Mohawk TV celebrates the 20th anniversary of the romantic cult classic Love Jones with Things You Didn't Know About Love Jones. The role of Nia Mosley in Love Jones was originally written for Jada Pinkett Smith. It was supposed to reunite Lorenz, Tate, and Jada Pinkett Smith, who had mad chemistry when they played teenage sweethearts in the 1994 romantic comedy Inkwell. But Jada turned down the role and it was given to Nia Long. Ironically, at the time Nia was playing Will Smith, a girlfriend Lisa Wilkes on The Fresh Prince of Bel-Air, a role Jada Pinkett Smith was originally supposed to play, but was too short at 5 feet, opposite of 6'2 Will Smith, thus leaving Nia Long to take the part. What's interesting is, on the same year Love Jones was released, Jada Pinkett Smith would marry Will Smith. The two will also celebrate their 20th anniversary this year on December 31st. Nia Long was thrilled to take the role of Nina Mosley in Love Jones. For one, with notable roles in movies like Boys in the Hood and Fridays, to her credit, Love Jones was actually Nia's first starring role in a motion picture. Another reason why Nia Long was so thrilled to take the role is poetry is a family legacy. Her father is Daughtry Doc Long, a well-known poet and creative writing teacher from Brooklyn, New York. Doc Long has had his poetry published in numerous journals and magazines, but his greatest legacy is his children, Nia Long and the Queen of Comedy, Samoa. Love Jones was written and directed by then production assistant Theodore Witcher, who got the green light and $10 million to make the film when he was only 24 years old. The story was loosely based on the life of the Chicago native Witcher and named after the classic R&B song Love Jones by Chicago's group Brighter Side of Darkness. As luck would have it, both struck gold with Love Jones. The irony is, Love Jones is their only hits for both Witcher and the group, known for their spoken word mixed with R&B hooks, Brighter Side of Darkness. Among the most memorable scenes in Love Jones was the scene where Darius and Nina had their last kiss. But this scene almost didn't happen. There was a big argument about that scene because everyone was like, black women don't like to get their hair wet, and the scene was unbelievable. This was confirmed when a studio screen test of black women revealed that most black women didn't believe that a black woman would stand in the rain with her hair uncovered to be in the moment. It was enough for the studio to order that the director and the cast reshoot the scene, this time under a L train viaduct. To the dismay of Nina Long and director, who said black women could be in the moment even if it meant a poofy ponytail the next day. The 1997 film, written and directed by Theodore Witcher and starred Lorenz Tate and Nia Long, was rare in many ways. For one, the film was the studio's attempt at making a modern film about African-American life that did not use violence and recreational drugs as an element in the story. Some say that the film was in response to criticism by the NAACP and members of the black community, who say that Hollywood's portrayal of African-Americans in films are overwhelmingly negative and stereotypical. In Love Jones, however, the smooth Lorenz Tate is a promising writer, poet, who meets the gifted photographer Nia Long in an upscale nightclub presenting jazz and poetry to young black professionals. Although the film received positive reviews, it only made $12.7 million at the box office. It cost $10 million to make. In relation, the film Menace to Society, a film where Tate plays a menacing young thug, Old Dog, cost $3.5 million to make and made $30 million at the box office. Nia Long's film Boys in the Hood cost $6.5 million to make and made $57.5 million at the box office. What does it mean? Was America ready for a love story about black young professionals? Some would suggest not in 1997, as gangster rap led by artists such as Tupac, Nas, Notorious B.I.G., and others was at its peak. It was a time where, for the first time, street poets telling their gripping stories of the black American struggles connected with the world and prepared an entire hip-hop culture from music to film to fashion. People didn't want to see black poets in swanky jazz clubs talking about metaphors of love, but street poets in the background of a housing project talking about the harsh reality of African-American life. Despite its bad timing, critics still put Love Jones at the pinnacle of black filmmaking, and the movie is regarded by many as one of the greatest modern black love stories ever written. The movie would eventually become a blueprint for future urban films such as Brown Sugar, The Best Man, Love and Basketball, How Stella Got Her Groove Back, and many more. Love Jones also brought poetry clubs from underground to mainstream audiences, as clubs across the country started featuring spoken word events. Russell Simmons even capitalized off the culture with his HBO series Deaf Poetry, and 20 years later, Love Jones is considered a cult classic and celebrated all over the world for its contributions in urban cinema.